All right. What I would like to do, in case I was going to do something davening, but okay, let's concentrate on the Haggadah. I have some notes that I've prepared, of course. Now, I just wanted to say the following. First of all, as the Haggadah, we all know this is a book of plan. It's all being planned. And the Higadeta Levincha, tell your child, and all the Torah, all the mitzvot, all the commandments. Now, the Haggadah was composed by the men of the General Assembly, prophets, Chachamim, from the time of Ezra and Nehemiah. Now, we know that Ezra and Nehemiah were the ones who returned after the destruction of the first temple. They returned with a lot of people from Babylonia. And then when the Haggadah was composed. There are some people think that it was only in the time when the Mishnah was started. Some of them think the Talmudic. Some think that it was even in the time of the Geonim, which is already 9th century. But it seems that it was before, of course. So now, let me, one second, start with, let me start here. I'm just opening the Haggadah. I haven't seen the Haggadah since last year. Okay. Now, as I said, this is a book of plans, and right at the beginning, and I will sing it for you, of course. Kadesh urechatz, you know, make kiddush, wash hands without bracha, karpas, and I will give you one melody that is very well known here in America. I found it here in America, so I don't even know how old it is. It cannot be too old. But and then I have also a Hasidic melody. If you're recording it, that's great. Please try to record it for yourselves. I know Sheila is doing it also. And it's all right. Let me see what key shall I take. Karepas yachatz Magid rachza Maotzi matza Maror korech Shulchan orech Zafon barech Alel nirza. Somewhat of a strange melody. Kadesh urechat, karpas yachat, magid rachza, motzi matza, maror korech, shulchan orech, zafun barech, alel nirtza. Be something Yemenite, but I have another one that our family sang, and also I brought it into the army when I was the cantor of the army. I brought it when we used to go to do the Seder in various camps, and I always was with Rabbi Goren, the chief rabbi, and he loved it and he learned it and he used to sing it, and it goes like this. Die, die, die. This is what we call in Hebrew the simanim of the Haggadah. These are the signs, these are the portions of the Haggadah. Kadesh is Kiddush. Rechatz, wash your hand without a bracha. Karpas, we eat the karpas. Yachatz, we take the matzah and we break it, and part of it we hide for the afikoma. Magid, then from Avadim Ayinu, we'll come to it in a minute, and I will sing you something there. This is really saying the Haggadah. And then Rachza, again, washing the hands, but this time with a bracha. And then we make the bracha, Birkat Motzi. We make the bracha, Amotzi Lechem Min Haaretz. And then, Asher Kiddushanu B'mitzvotav V'tzivanu, Al Achilat Matzah, we thank the Almighty for ordering us, teaching us, instructing us to eat the matzah. To the first night, it's a must. We have to eat something of the matzah because it's important. Then we have the moror, the bitter herb, and then we have the korech. After the eating, we take before we make a sandwich and the korech together, and then we say the hillel. Used to do it especially, and that's a hillel sandwich, as we call it. And then Shulchan Orech, in other words, we eat the meal. And then Tzafun, we look for the Afikoman and we bring it out. We cannot conclude the Haggadah without eating the part of the Afikoman. Then Barech, we bench the grace after meal. Then we say Hallel, praising God. This is Psalms. We say it in the davening in the mornings. By the way, that there is a custom that we say Hallel. Some people say Hallel after the first and second night of Pesach, after the Maariv service, after the evening service, we say the Hallel. And I tell you, I haven't had that in shuls. Many years, not in Johannesburg and not in London, and not we were in the hotel. There were a lot of people requested that they have a minhag that they say the Hallel. So some people walked out, and some people stayed for Hallel. And then Nirtza, that means that we conclude the Haggadah. All right, now. The Kiddush, okay, we say the Kiddush, I don't want to spend much on time on that. And then, by the way, let's not forget, this year, the first night of Pesach is Saturday night. Actually, I should make the Kiddush for the first night because it's a Kiddush and Havdalah, both Kiddush and Havdalah. So maybe I should just once sing it for you. I think I'll do it that way. Baruch atah Adoshem Elokeinu Melech Haolam Borei Peri Agafen. Baruch atah Adoshem Elokeinu Melech Haolam Asher bachar banu mikol ha'am Veromemanu mikol lashon Vekideshanu Bemitzvosav Vatiten lanu Adoshem Elokeinu Beyavah Adim le simcha Chagim uzmanim leshason es yom chag matzos hazeh zeman cheuseinu mikra kodesh zecher litzias mitzrayim. Mekadesh Israel Behazemani. Now comes the part of the Havdalah, in other words, to distinguish between the Shabbat, and we go right into Yom Tov. And it's a Kiddush with Havdalah together. Baruch atah Adoshem, Elokeinu melech haolam, borei meorei ha'esh. Baruch atah Adoshem, Elokeinu melech haolam, amavdil ben kodesh lechol, Bein or lechoshech, Bein Yisrael lamim, Bein yom ha-shevi le-sheish yes yeme ha-masu, Bein kedushas shabos, Likdushas yom etod, Yivdalta, Ekidasha es yom ha-shevi, Sorry, give me a minute. We have to do it. I'm until another one. Okay. Ben Gushayim, Yivdal, Tavikidas,
Yom HaShavim, Shechet.
Yes, yes. Misheshet Yemei HaMaseh, Kidash Tavikidas, Tavikidasamcha Yisrael. Baruch ato Adoshem, amavdil ben kodesh le kodesh. Baruch ato Adoshem, Elokeinu melech haolam. Shehechayanu vekiyimanu vehigiyanu lazeman hazeh. And we drink the wine. Okay, then we have the washing. Now, we have, I want to sing you a Yemenite melody. We have Halachma Aniya. This is the bread of affliction. And it goes like this. I have it from Israel. Alachma anya di achalo, achalo avhatana, veyarade arade mitzayim. Kol dichvin yeseh veyechol, kol dichrich yeseh veyivsach, ashatacha. Lashana haba veyarad Yisrael, ashatavde. La shana haba, and Okay, so this melody, if you don't want to sing it, we just say. Then comes the Manishtana. Now the Manishtana, there is something that I would love to spend just a moment to explain the musical side of it. Explanations, translations, you have it in the Agadah, so you don't, we'll come to it. Now, Manishtana, this is already, there is a way of chanting it. And I like the way it's done in America very much. Because there is something what we call in Jewish musicology, learning Steiger, the style of learning. When one goes to an old fashioned yeshiva and you learn a page of the Talmud, as they say in Yiddish, a blat gemore. Man ishana laila ze mikol alelo shebechol alelo anochlim chameitzu matza alaila ze kulo matza. And we can sing man ishtana, man ishtana, alayla ze, man ishtana, man ishtana, alayla ze, shebechol alaylo sanu ochlin, she'arir hakos, alayla ze maro. And we can sing again, Manishtana, Manishtana, Alayla ze, Manishtana, Manishtana, Alayla ze. Shebechol alaylos einanu matbilin afilu pam echas, Alayla ze, shtei in the yeshiva with the thumb, they learn the Talmud with a thumb like that. However, there is exactly, and so we sing, or we can sing the famous Israeli Manishtana Laila Ze Mikol Alelo, Mikol Alelo, Shebechol Alelos Anuchim Chameitzu Matzah, Chameitzu Matzah, Alayla Ze, Alayla Ze, Kulo Matzah, Alayla Ze, Alayla Ze, Kulo Matzah, Shebechol Alaylos Anu Ochlin She'ar She'ar Yerakos, Alayla Ze, Alayla Ze, Alayla Ze, Alayla Ze, Alayla Ze. And the next, let me do it quick, Alayla ze, kulan esubim, alayla ze.
laila se a laila se kula yesu.
Okay, now begins the Haggadah itself. The Haggadah itself. Now, Avadim Ainu Lefaro B'Mitzrayim. I will give you once how we chant it. And then I'll give you a lovely melody that we sing from Israel. I grew up on that, and now it is part of our family. Avadim Ainu Lefaro B'Mitzrayim. ויוציאנו עד השם אלוקינו משם ביד חזקה ובזרוע נטויה. ואילו לא הוציא הקדוש ברוך הוא עשיו עושינו ממצרים, הרי אנו ובנינו ובני בנינו משובדים היינו לפרעה במצרים. ואפילו כולנו חכמים, כולנו נבונים, כולנו זקנים, כולנו יודעים עשה תוארה, מצווה עלינו לספר ביציאת מצרים, וכל המרבה לספר ביציאת מצרים, הרי זה משובח. Now, here is a melody.
Avadim ayinu, ayinu, ata b'nei chorin, b'nei chorin. Avadim ayinu, ata b'nei chorin. Avadim ayinu, ata b'nei chorin, b'nei chorin, b'nei chorin.
Of course, we don't have all the words of this Avadim Ayinu. However, we sing it always.
Avadim Ayinu, Ayinu, ata b'nei chorin, b'nei chorin. Avadim, Ayinu, ata, ata, b'nei chorin. Avadim, chorin, b'nei chorin. Ata, ata, b'nei chorin, b'nei chorin.
Now, we say the Haggadah, we say the Haggadah. I'm getting to some Amda. Oscar, are you with us? Oscar, where are you?
Hey, I am here listening intently.
Okay. Now, the rest...
I think you're going to have to come with your piano to my Seder.
Okay. Now, we say all the Haggadah, the words, that is, until we get to Vehisha Amda. What is Vehisha Amda? Vehi, it stood for us. He, this is the covenant that God gave us to our forefathers, foreparents, and for ourselves, despite the fact that not one nation will try to annihilate us, and in every generation they were trying to do that, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, God saves us from them. Okay, we can discuss a lot of things about that. I don't want to go into it. I love the melody. I have some problems. I mean, after all, we had a Shoah and we lost 6 million. And then after that, we fought for the state of Israel And ever since, all the nations were trying to annihilate us, but HaKadosh Baruch Hu Matzileinu, eventually he saves us. We pay a lot, but he saves us. And Vehisha Amra. A song, it's almost an anthem of the Jewish people that we sing it for the Agada. Let me continue saying the Agada, reading
just
in Hebrew, English.
That's very Israeli. Yes. It's
what?
That Nigun is very Israeli. It has that tam of the Israeli.
Yes, but it's really a Hasidic melody.
Oh, really? Okay.
It's really a Hasidic melody that it means, from what I understood from my father, Alav Shalom,
wow, was
it my grandfather sang it also. So it goes back to Europe somewhere. And nobody seems to know who composed that melody, but yes, it is a love melody. All right. Then we have Dayenu. Dayenu is, if God would not have done this and that and other, would have been enough, would have been sufficient. Yeah. Now, we have the very famous melody. Savahem Shefati Wadavelo, until we finish this whole poem, and it gives us a lot of the Jewish history from the miracle of Egypt, when eventually God killed the firstborn of the Egyptians, And then when the Red Sea was split, and in the desert, God gave us for 40 years food, the manna, and so on and so forth. We have another melody that is in our family, and I've known this melody before. I knew the melody I just sang. I said, here is a lovely melody. If you want to learn it, Ellen, you can learn it very quickly. Oscar, you can learn it. Everybody can learn it. It's beautiful. Family, when we have our Seder. Last year it was just Beatrice and I because of the pandemic, but Ellis sang it, he knows it, he grew up on that with the children, with the grandchildren, with his children. And so now we continue saying the Haggadah until we come to the words, and that is a modern Israeli melody based on Hasidic motifs. Bechol dor vador chayav adam lirot et atzmo ki'ilu hu yatza mimitzrayim. In every generation, one is obligated to see oneself as if he and she came out from Egypt. Listen to this lovely melody. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Ellen, thank you. Ellen, this is typically Israeli.
Yeah, that is typically Israeli, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
It was only a small part of the previous one, towards the end, Israeli. I agree. This is 100%.
That's a melody that we sing. Now we come to Hallel, the first part of Hallel. And the first one, we have Lefichach anachnu chayavim lehodos lehallel leshabeach. We are commanded, we are obligated to thank, to praise, to exalt, to heighten, to bless, to the one who did for us all these miracles. In our family, this is a melody that nobody knows. I think it comes from Hungary, from family in Hungary. Lefichach anachnu chayavim. Therefore, we have to. It goes like this. Lefichach anachnu chayavim leodos lehallel leshabeach lefanu lerumem leader levarech lehallel lemi shasta lavoseinu eskolanisim haele otsianu meyavedos lechirus miyagon lesimcha me'ever leyor umeyafela leyor gador umishibur legeula venom lefanav shira chadasha. Do it once more. What's that, Josh? It is. Because God took us from slavery to freedom, from sadness to happiness, from mourning to a holiday, from darkness to great light. Quickly, good luck, it's beautiful. Then we have the Betzes Israel Mimitzrayim. There are so many melodies. I'm sure those who have been davening with me for years is, you know, this is, I never get the chance really to explain. But the melody of the chess is Israel Mimitzrayim. When the Jewish people came out Mimitzrayim from Egypt, Bes Yaakov, the house of Jacob, rejoices. And the melody that I sing in our shul, whenever I daven, it's an Italian Jewish melody. I can tell you a quick story. I once gave a performance in Rome, and I inserted this as a concert piece. And the chief rabbi of Rome came over to me after the concert. He says, "Where did you get that melody? It belongs to us." I said, "Well, I told everybody this is Italian Jewish melody." So here, Betzes Israel. In between is another meaning. Betes Israel, Mimitzrayim, Bes Yaakov, Me'ameloes, Aisa Yehuda, Lekodesho, Israel, a combination of the Italian Judaic melody or Judeo-Italian melody and the melody that he sang in Israel and came to America and everybody sing it. And whenever I daven Hallel, of course I sing it and everybody sings along. It's just a wonderful thing. All right. Then we have the meal, the matzah, the maror, the herbs, sandwich, the Hillel sandwich. If you would see this Haggadah, ah, gepatchket it is. Take a look. From so much wine and matzah and everything. And charoshes and everything. But I love this Haggadah. I don't move without it. I just love it. Okay, and then of course comes the benching, Shira Malos. Listen to that. Everybody knows a melody. Shira Malos. But you know, this Shira Malos attributed to Rosenblatt, but he did not really compose it. But I don't want to go now into the into that machlokes. One day we'll get a chance. The title will be Melodies Attributed to Chazonim, but not necessarily composed by them. But there is a Yekishe Frankfurt melody for Shira Maalot, because it has a motif of Pesach of Adir Hu. Listen to that. Malos beshuvadoshem et shivatzion ayinu techolmin azim alesechat bino oleshoneinu ina az yom lovay goyim igdil adoshem lasosim eile igdil Hashem, la sasimanu ha'ino zereichim. Shuvad Hashem, eshevisenu kafikim banegev. Hazorim berim ha'heberim ha'ikto. Loch yelecho vacho no semel shechazara bo yavo verina no se alo mosach. Real German melody. Real one.
Yes, remark.
Yossi, someone told me that the Shira Maloch, Hamalot, was once considered, when they were considering the national anthem, HaTikva, this was proposed as being a possible anthem for the state of Israel. Any truth to that?
Absolutely. I've been talking about it in my lectures a couple of times, and not only that it was considered, but it lost by one vote to HaTikva. Can you imagine that Shira Maalot, not this melody though, Oscar, but the melody will be Shira Maalot Beshuv Adoshem of all, but that we sing almost every Shabbos. I just want to drink.
Amen.
Amen.
But the first one. Saying no coffee in my name. Okay, now we have the benching, all the melodies benching. We don't have to go through that one. Everybody knows that. I want to touch some of the songs of the end of the Haggadah. We have the Hallel, and in the Hallel we have Hashem Zecharanu. Hashem Zecharanu Yevarech, Yevarech Hesbeis Yisroel, Yevarech Hesbeis Aharon, Yevarech Yirei Yadusha. Atanim imadori, Ayosef Hashem Alechem, Alechem ve'al benechem, Beruchim batem la'ashem, Osef shamayim ba'al, Hashamayim shamayim ladoshem, Ve'aretz nasam limeyadam, Nisim ye alleluia, velo kol yodei duma, v'anachno nevarech ya, me'ata le'ad olam, alleluia. Okay, we continue with the Hallel. Od Hakyanitani, we know that from Shul. Oh, oh, Od Hakyanitani, Vateili Shua. Od Hakyanitani, Vateili Shua. Masua boni, aisa le rospina. Even masua boni, aisa le rospina. Es kibosho, aisa zos ni flase. Es kibosho, aisa zos. In the flowers, between them, there I am, now let me touch on the ending, the songs of the end. Gada, give me a second. We say what we say. Yeah, first of all, we have Chasar Sidur, Chasal Sidur Pesach. The end.
Oh,
Shana haba Yerushalayim abnaya. Shana haba Yerushalayim.
You know, I had once a chazan whom I admire so much, Moshe Kusevitsky, doing a second Seder in Tel Aviv. So at that Pesach, I had the Seder with Rav Goren in Eilat, and almost the entire cabinet of Israel was in Eilat to be with Rav Goren and the prime minister at that time. To be there, Moshe Dayan was there, Golda Meir was there, all of them. And I remember Rav Goren said to Moshe Dayan, Moshe, why don't you eat some gefilte fish that the Rebbetzin made? And Moshe Dayan said, why? The gefilte fish from the army is not enough kosher? So Rav Goren says, of course it is kosher. Then Dayan said, then I will eat the gefilte fish like all the other soldiers. I don't care about the Rebbetzin's gefilte fish. But then I had a helicopter that took me from Eilat to Tel Aviv. And in Tel Aviv, a car waited, an army car, rushed me to the Sheraton, the old Sheraton Hotel, and Moshe Kusevitsky was already conducting the Seder. When he saw me, he got so excited. I was one of his boys, no? Why am I saying it? I sang Chasal Sidur Pesach. It changed a little bit, and you will catch right away why. And if you don't, I will tell you. So Chasal Sidur Pesach Keilecha Hasur Kechol Mishpato Vechu Kashezachilo lesaderosu, kashezachilo lesaderosu. Now he changed. Did you hear what he did? He changed it. When it came, Peduim Letzion Berina, they will be free and be brought to Zion, to Yerushalayim, happily. So what? Atikva, the melody of Atikva, coming to Eretz Israel, Atikva. And when he sang it, he broke down. He started crying. I'll never forget it. And okay, now we have a couple of songs at the end, which I would still like. I don't want to finish this session without yeah. Okay. Kilona e kiloya e. Kilona e kilo no e kilo ya e kilo no e kilo ya. Ayati rabi mlocha machoka lacha kedut dar yamu lo lecha ulecha lecha kilecha lecha af lecha lecha adoshem amlalcha kilo no e kilo yo e kilo no e kilo ya. Ayda kula bi mlocha Haduka lacha, asika v'yamru lo lecha ulecha, lecha ki lecha, lecha af lecha, lecha doshem amba melacha. Ki lo noe, ki lo oe, ki lo noe, ki lo ya. Tararam bam 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 bye. Tararam bam 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 bye. Dam bam 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 bye. Dai dam bam 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 bye. Yam bam 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 bye. Tararam bam 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 bye. Dai lai nai dai dai dam bam bam. Kilo kilo noe kilo ya. Dai dam bam 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 bam. And we have all of them the same melody. That's one thing. Then Adir Hu Yivne Beito Bekarov. Here is a melody that is typical Pesach, because we use it, this the motifs, the musical motifs, in the davening also. And Adir Hu. One second. Yeah. Adiru, adiru, ivne beiso bekaru, bimera, bimera, leyameinu bekaru. Keil bene, bene beisha bekaru. Dolehu, da gulehu, even ebe isabekaru, bimera, bimera, beya, minu bekaru, keil bene, keil bene, bene ebe isabekaru, aduhu, basiku, zakaihu, Chasidehu, even ebe isabekaru, bimera, bimera, keil bene, keil bene, bene ebe isabekaru, and so on until we finish that song. I must tell you, you know, the Germans all together and German Jews don't have very much sense of humor. Mm-hmm. Now, there is some kind of a minhag which started as a joke and it became a tradition among German Jews, Frankfurt, Berlin, Leipzig, Hamburg, other places. And what are the words? Adir Hu, God is strong, Yivne beiso bekarov. He will build his house soon. Meaning really the Beit HaMikdash, the temple. Bimheira, bimheira, quickly, quickly, in our time, soon. Kel bene, God, please build, God, please build, build it soon. So we are talking about building. And in German, it says, Bauen. Bauen means to build. So the minhag that developed, the minhag that developed in Frankfurt is when Jews came the first day in the morning to shul. One came to the other and he asked him in German, "Sagen Sie bitte, haben Sie gut gebaut? Tell me, please, did you build well?" So the other one says, "Ist das möglich, so zu machen, so schnell?" "Ach, kein Zweifel," he says. "Is it really so possible to do it so quickly?" And he said, "Well, that doesn't matter, it's okay." So that's a German joke that when they say it, they burst out laughing. All right, so they do. You know, we use it in the davening, for example, Hodul Adoshem, Ki Tov, Ki Leolam Chasdo. And my classic illustration is the following. Imagine that there is an astronaut who is an Orthodox Jew. An Orthodox Jew, or a Jew for that matter. And he goes up, well, I call it on the Sputnik, not what we call today a Sputnik, which is for the No, for Chisun, no? It's
vaccine.
Not what
vaccine.
There is today in Russia. Yeah, what there is in Russia, they call it Sputnik. So that Jew, you know, because this Sputnik goes around the earth so quickly, so he puts on tefillin, takes them off, and 2 minutes later puts it on again, because meanwhile it's a day and a night and a day and a night and a day and a night. So then he comes back to Earth. He's a frum guy. He doesn't know what day it is. He doesn't know if it's Shabbos. He doesn't know whether it is Yom Tov. He doesn't know anything. But since he's a frum guy, what does he do? He goes to shul. Comes into shul, and here is the illustration that I like to always say. He hears this melody. He knows right away it's Pesach. Or when he comes into shul and it's Shavuos, he doesn't know. There is the piyu that we say before we learn the Torah, Akdomes. Yeah. Akdom os milin veshara yoshusa avla shakilena arman ureshusa. Ah, he hears this melody, that's Shavuos. He doesn't care about the words because it's in Aramaic anyhow, and who understands Aramaic? All right, so we have Adir Hu. So this melody is really a classic, and it goes back at least to the time of the Maharil, the great sage, who was also a chazan in Germany. It must be about 600 years old, at least, if not more. All right, and then we have Echad Mi Yodea. Echad Mi Yodea. Echad Mi Yodea. Echad Eloheinu Shebashamayim Uvaaretz Shnayim Yodea, Shnayim Ani Yodea, Shnei Luchos Abris, Echad Eloheinu Shebashamayim Uvaaretz. Or we sing it, for example, number 3. Shlosha Ani Yodea, Shlosha Ani Yodea, Shlosha avos, shneinu chosabris, echad Eloheinu, 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 sheba shamayim u'aretz. And bam bam. Here is a melody. Bam 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 bam. Right, then we have the last one is a Chad Gadya. Everybody. Chad Gadya.
Chad Gadya.
Zabin Abba Bitrezuz Chad Gadya.
Chad Gadya.
Very good, Oscar, you're improving.
Anything I would do would be better than it was.
And the melody continues. And the last one, Ve'asa Kodosh Baruch Hu Ve'shachat le'malach ha'mavet Ve'shachat le'shochet Ve'shachat le'sora de'shata le'maya Ve'chava le'nura Ve'sarav le'chutra de'yika le'chaleba Ve'shach le'shomera Ve'yachla le'kaliya Ve'zabit Abba Bitrezuz Chag Gadya. Chag Gadya. And with this, we finish the order.